A non-meeting turned into a public hearing last night as members of the Board of Education received an earful from the public about their failure to renew Donnie Poston's contract as director of schools. The courtroom filled to overflowing as hundreds of parents, teachers, and students filled the seats, lined the walls, and crammed into the outside lobby in an effort to hear and to voice their support for Poston. The loudest noise of the night came when Poston entered the room, to cheers and a standing ovation. The applause continued as a series of speakers took the microphone to voice the reasons they feel Poston should keep his job. The applause reached a zenith when Board Chairman Josh Parker, his voice breaking down from emotion, added that he too supports Poston and refused to convene the meeting, which some board members requested to bring a search for a new director. The chairman must call the meeting to order, or if he refuses, a vote of a majority of the board is required to convene the meeting. Parker announced, adding, "I refuse to convene the meeting." Parker then called for a vote. Johnny Burge, J.L. Collins, Johnny Creekmore, Eugene Lawson, and Rector Miller all voted to convene the meeting, but they failed to gain the necessary sixth vote. Parker then declared the meeting over to loud applause. The testimony in Poston's favor ranged from AFT president and teacher Sharon Marlowe, who complimented the board on the progress made in some areas, but added, "The most awesome thing by far that this board has done was in hiring Mr. Poston as director. He has returned unity and he has brought back honesty to the office," Marlowe added. "Everything he has done has been with the best interest of our children, the parents, and employees at here." Campbell County High School student Sarah Roick added her comments that, "We have had four directors in 4 years, but now we students feel we have a voice, that Mr. Poston listens to us." While Campbell County High School student body president Whitney Sawyer said, "I'm concerned that I have to defend my director to my school board, reminding the board we students may not be able to vote, but our parents do." James Slusher was the only speaker to say anything negative, reminding the board that Campbell County's ACT test scores are far below state averages. Slusher also tried to lay the board's decision to install solar panels on school buildings at Poston's feet, which brought a sharp retort from board member Mike Orrick when Slusher hinted that the panels might make roofs unsafe. Orrick added Dixie Roofing, Mike Malicote, to respond to Slusher's comments, but Parker pointed out that the agenda for the called meeting did not allow that discussion. Malicote agreed to answer questions about the solar project to any parents willing to stay following the meeting. While Parker warned the audience about interruptions, Slusher's comments were obviously not well received. As soon as it became obvious that he was not supporting Poston, many in the audience suffered loud coughing spells, seemingly spreading from one person to another in a scene reminiscent of the movie Animal House. In the end, nothing has been resolved except a very clear message to the five board members who appear to favor replacing Poston. The director's contract will still expire in June unless at least seven board members vote to extend it. That means that two board members would have to show a change of heart, and also means that the board can look forward to at least four more months of packed courtrooms whenever they meet. Yuma County High School teacher has resigned following an investigation by school officials and the Department of Children's Services. Jason Ivey, who taught Spanish and coached tennis at the school, submitted a letter of resignation January 29th to Assistant Director of Schools, Larry Nidefer. The allegations pointed to a pattern of classroom behavior that included locker room language and inappropriate comments. Nidefer said the investigation by DCS was standard operating procedure with situations involving minors. Ivy was never accused of physically abusing anyone, therefore, no criminal charges came out of the investigation. Ivy also retains his teaching license. During the course of the investigation, Ivy had been removed from his regular classroom at Campbell County High School and placed in the Adult Education Center at the Old Wessel Follett School. On January 8th, Ivy sent a letter of apology to Campbell County High School Principal Jamie Wheeler, and in the letter, he admitted that his conduct was inappropriate and that he had learned a lesson to treat students with the respect they deserve. That letter was sent to Wheeler exactly 3 weeks before he resigned from his teaching position with the Campbell County Public Schools. A Campbell County High School junior remains in the county jail at this hour on multiple charges. Chief Deputy Aaron Evans with the Campbell County Sheriff's Department tells WLAF that 18-year-old Chris Stone of La Follette was taken into custody Thursday on the Campbell County High School campus. Loud explosions that sounded like gunfire in a hallway near the front office sent students scrambling for cover yesterday morning. Stone initially denied setting off the explosion, but recanted when witnesses said otherwise. As he handed over 10 explosives to officers, Stone went on to say that he also had a glass pipe that he admits he uses for smoking pot. It's believed that the explosives are some sort of fireworks. Stone is expected to make bond and leave the jail before the day is over. And today marks the start to Dr. Clarence Duncan's 29th consecutive year on radio. Duncan serves as pastor at the Bethel Baptist Church and is heard every day on 1450 WLAF radio. The broadcasts are Monday through Friday from 9:30 to 9:45 a.m. and Sunday mornings from 8 to 8:30. Duncan has the longest running radio ministry in the history of Campbell County Radio. And that's our news. Stay tuned. Back with a press release for you. Just a moment.
Hey, Big Josh, we've got our birthday and anniversary club on this Friday evening. And the birthday and anniversary club, of course, brought to you by WLAF and Eastside Pizza and Deli. And we want to tell you that today on our birthday list, Chastity Danielle Slayback turns 24 years old. Happy birthday to you, Chastity Danielle. And Roger Greenwood's having a birthday. Happy birthday, Roger. Lisa Sanders is celebrating today. Happy birthday, Lisa. Francis Roberts turned 63 years old today. Happy birthday to you, Francis. And Shirley McCain is having a birthday. Happy birthday, Shirley. And Hattie Griffith is 21 years old today. Happy birthday to you, Hattie. And looking at our anniversaries, Sherman and Zora Ballard celebrate 57 years today, and Jock and Darlene Peebly are celebrating number 31. Now, we want to tell you this. If you're celebrating your birthday today or your anniversary, and for some reason we don't have your name on our list, we want you to have a great day regardless. But the only way that you can qualify to win a birthday dinner for two or an anniversary dinner for two is if we have your name on our list, and that qualifies you for the drawing on Friday. And this week we want to congratulate our birthday winner from Tuesday. Tony Phillips had a birthday, and congratulations, Tony. You're our winner this week. And our anniversary club winners, Zora and Sherman Ballard. Congratulations to you all. And we hope all of you have had a great week and are having a great day today. And good Lord willing, we'll do all this again next week. But remember that the birthday and the anniversary club is brought to you by our very own WLAF and Eastside Pizza and Deli. Hey, stop up and check those guys out, will ya? You taught me.